our original opening that went into boarding was not the way that I always pitched it. It was this idea that you saw the family first as people, and then kind of gradually revealed that they were superheroes. So we started this thing at what we thought was a good American kind of way to start it, and that's him getting to know the neighbors at a neighborhood barbecue.
Young married couple, new in the neighborhood.
Right, and they're making jokes, trying to fit in, and someone says something to Helen.
A commodities broker, that sounds intriguing.
Well, it can be quite a challenge, but I gotta be honest, I eat it for breakfast. And what do you do, Helen?
I'm a homemaker.
This is based on a thing that my wife has had to go through. She worked in film editing, and when we first had our kids, there was a decision about whether or not she should continue working because she made good money. And I said, look, as long as we can bring in enough money, it'd be great to have the kids have a mother around all the time. And we made it work. But one thing that she noticed was that when you're talking about work, everyone could connect with that. Everyone got it. Everyone, you know, hey, you're another fellow working person, isn't it, you know, this difficult and all that. Once she said that she, you know, was a mother, or that she worked in the house, sure, their eyes glazed over and they kind of dismissed what she did.
Throw away my prime years trailing after a bunch of snotty kids? No thank you. Hello, no thanks. Hello, I want to do something with my life.
Wait a minute. You consider raising a family nothing?
I love the idea of a superhero defending, you know, being a mom. Yeah. So I like that moment, and I'm sorry that we don't have something like that in the movie.
The first time we realize these people aren't normal people is when he gets distracted by the argument Helen's having about motherhood and a professional life, and Bob chops off his own fingers.
Yeah. Well, see, that's the thing, is if you are invulnerable, relatively invulnerable, and you have to pretend anybody catches you being invulnerable, then you've got to go through a tremendous amount of problems to try to convince the world that you're not invulnerable.
Right.
And you have to pretend like you're injured when you're not. And I just thought there's another side to this superhero thing, you know, the burden of trying to hide, you know.
The secret.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm super. How you been, Mike?
Never better. Thank God for the weekend. Hey, everyone, I want you to meet my new neighbors, Bob and Helen Smith. Helen, Bob, meet Beth Anderson. Beth's a commodities broker down at Philippi Investments.
Oh, a commodities broker. That sounds intriguing.
Well, it can be quite a challenge, but I gotta be honest. I eat it for breakfast. And what do you do, Helen?
I'm a homemaker. Well, we only have one child.
But she can be quite demanding, can't you, little boo-boo?
You know, but motherhood is really much more demanding
nice
than I ever thought
hey,
it
Kevin, how
could
are you?
Be.
Oh, hey, Bob, I'd like you to meet,
Dick Schaefer.
Hey, Dick, Bob Smith, and this is my wife, Helen.
Pleased to meet you, Helen.
Hi, Dick.
Dick's thinking about buying the house across the street.
Well, everybody on the block loves that house.
Hey, everybody on the block has that house.
It was nice meeting you, Dick.
Hey, Bob, can you give me a hand chopping up these steaks?
Sure.
Throw away my prime years trailing after a bunch of snotty kids? No thank you. Hello, no thanks. Hello, I want to do something with my life.
Wait a minute.
You consider raising a family nothing?
Well, it's fine if you're not suited for more substantial things.
Do you have any idea how much suffering would fail to take root if more people were just good parents?
Well,
what's more important than that? What kind of job? A job saving lives? Is that important?
Yeah.
What about risking my life?
Well,
what about confronting evil on a daily basis for years so that people like you can sleep in safety and security? Would you consider that kind of job substantial?
Yeah, I would. Yes, I would. Well, that's the job I gave up for my new job, raising a family. And nobody's going to tell me it's any less important.
I am so sorry. I meant no offense. What on earth did you used to do?
You don't even know where the hospital is, do you?
No.
Do you?
You think anybody noticed? I'm sorry, honey. I know what this means.
A couple of months of bandages, scar makeup after that.
Well, we wanted a normal life.
Did we? I think I found him.
Honey?
I heard it.
A burglar?
I don't know.
Well?
Okay.
Wake up and be sharp. You know you're sloppy when you're not awake.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, and honey, don't hurt him. We're starting fresh. And honey, don't break anything, okay? I just got the house organized.
All right, already. I'm gonna try to enjoy this anyway. Don't move. What did you take? The silver? My grandmother gave that to me. That grandma! What big teeth she had! Syndrome. Don't act surprised, Incredible. I mean, Mr. Smith. You didn't really think that getting a new life would absolve you of the last one, did you?
You had to know I'd be back to settle accounts. And the best part is, they don't even know I've escaped yet.
You'll be back inside before they do.
Cool, huh? Little something I was working on when you sent me to the Skookum House! Good ideas never go out of style, so here we are. Hey, don't bother with 911, sweetheart. I've cut the wires. Just leave the scene, okay?
You know, you really should remodel. This place would be nice. If you opened it up.
Oh, I like that.
Don't you think?
It's airy. I believe I said you could go. Now don't try to help him out, you little scamp, and I'll let you live.
It's not your fault. You just shouldn't have gotten involved with a superhero.
Oh, no. Elastigirl? You married Elastigirl? And had a kid? It's a whole family of supers! Looks like I've hit the jackpot! And you are breaking the law, Mr. Incredible. You know supers aren't supposed to breed.
Wait a minute.
Forget it. He cut the wires, remember?
Do you smell gas?
Grab on!
I remember in one of the earliest meetings I had with the sort of Pixar, they call it the Brain Trust. It's kind of a small group of other directors and story people that look at each other's films. They talked about what is the thing that's worst about them going into hiding. Are they avoiding lawsuits, or are they avoiding, you know, people coming after them? Villains coming after you that have a grudge against you, if they found out that Clark Kent was Superman and could track Clark Kent down to his home with his wife and kids, that's dramatic. That's much more visceral. The lawsuit thing is what I always had pitched, because to me that's a very mundane thing to bring down a superhero, which is kind of the whole vibe of this film is the mundane and the fantastic, you know. But I recognized that the other one had a visceral value. So I came up with this syndrome character, and the thing that was interesting about it was that everyone, when we did this sequence, responded to Syndrome much more than the villain that had been a part of my original pitch, which was this Zarek character.
Right.
We ended up going back to my original pitch. But the thing that we got out of it that was valuable was the villain.
Who's super now? I'm Syndrome, your nemesis edit.
Syndrome.
Don't act surprised, Incredible. I mean, Mr. Smith.
I loved him invading their house. The idea of him showing up at the end of the film in the house was always in my original pitch. But the moment that I miss is using Bob as a battering ram to wreck his own home.
We took that moment and translated it into the film, but it just doesn't have that same...
It's in there, but it's
symbolic
not...
Symbolic impact.
No.
As we did in the home and house.
And the moment that I miss most of all is him having the mom and dad frozen in the ray and hearing the sound of the baby and going... And moving down the hall towards the baby's room,
I remember, yeah.
With mom and dad floating in the air, and they're unable to do anything about that. I think we made the right decision in terms of what's in the movie, what the movie is. Mm-hmm. I don't think we made a mistake, but I miss those aspects of this moment. Mm-hmm. And there was a particular feeling that I got from that we don't have that feeling. We have a lot of good feelings in the movie. But we don't have that specific one, and I kind of wish that we did.